My brothers and sisters, Allah asks us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to travel the earth looking at what has happened to the previous nations in order for us to take heed and to learn a lesson. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also instructs us to read about the previous nations. Therefore, in the Quran, in many places, He has told us about the previous nations, what they were involved in, the messengers that came to them, what exactly those messengers said, how the response was, and the time they were given thereafter, the type of punishment that they received. And Allah says, all these stories have in them lessons for those with sound intellect. In the same way, Allah says, if you were to travel the land, you will see people whom we've destroyed before you. They had more than you. They were much more powerful than you. Don't think for a moment that Allah is incapable of dealing with you. Now, I know this might sound harsh to some, but it is necessary as a reminder. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is simply trying to bring us closer to Him in many different ways, giving us the reminders of being good, the reminders of obeying instruction, as well as staying away from prohibition. What would happen if we were to leave the instructions or engage in the prohibitions? And what happened to those in the past who did not obey? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in verse number 6, as well as in fact verse number 6 and 11 of this particular surah, Suratul An'am. Allah says, أَلَمْ يَرَوْا كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ مَكَّنَّاهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَا لَمْ نُمَكِّنْ لَكُمْ. Do they not see how many of the previous generations we have destroyed before them, whom we had actually given much more than what we had given them? Subhanallah. And then Allah says, قُلْ سِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ ثُمَّ انظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الْمُكَذِّبِينَ. Say, travel on the earth and then see what has happened to those who belied us. Subhanallah. I think this is something important, because when we read the stories of the previous nations, as much as there is a warning within them, there is a sense of comfort that justice does prevail. There is a sense of comfort for those who are oppressed, that oppression does not last. Take a look at the Prophet Noah, the Prophet Abraham, the Prophet Ismail, and all of these, Ismail alayhi salam, may peace be upon them all, Ibrahim alayhi salam in the Arabic language. Take a look at Musa, Moses, may peace be upon him. What happened? How was the Pharaoh destroyed? In all of these stories, there is comfort. Comfort for those who are being wronged and oppressed, that you know what? The Almighty's punishment is definitely real. He has done it in the past and He will do it in the future. But at the same time, the warning is for us too. If you are an oppressor, if you are creating crises in the lives of those who are innocent, subhanallah, you need to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only give you a short time, after which He will catch up with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a lesson from all angles. Like I say, comfort for those in crisis, and a warning for those who are creating crises. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly bless every single one of us.